In Copenhagen, someone asked Daniel Muggleton and I about the most ridiculous experience we had while on tour in Europe. So this clip is a combination of us telling the story, the actual footage of it happening, and some of the fight.
What's the most ridiculous experience you've had so far on this tour?
Where in the Netherlands are you from? Or what is that accent?
I was living in the Netherlands.
Really? I just picked a fucking country. I was kidding around.
I missed your show last year when you came to the Netherlands. I lived in Utrecht.
Are you from, so you're from the States or Canada?
Canada,
okay. That's why you sound a little bit like me, but also are polite. Okay, got it. Canada is where I'm from when I travel in Europe.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a real easy one. It's just like you do something fuck, you're like, oh, I'm so sorry, I'm Canadian. Okay, bye. Straight up. So sorry, what was the question? So
most ridiculous.
Yeah, the most ridiculous experience you've had on this tour so far.
On this tour, most ridiculous experience. The
fight? What about the fight? The fight was...
Oh yeah, the fight.
The fight. You guys are like, just like, the fight didn't spring to mind immediately. It's been a long fucking trip. Alright? Yeah. But yeah, that was the post-show, a guy, a big fan.
So it was in Nottingham. Oh no, it was Northampton. No, Nottingham was ridiculous just because it's a city that is pretending that Robin Hood is a documentary. For their tourism. Like, they basically everything... I was staying on the corner of Friar Way and Maid Marian Street. I was like, you're fucking kidding me, right? But Northampton was weirder.
It was a good show.
It was a great show. Amazing it was show. Without this incident, it would have been the best show of the trip.
Yeah.
You guys could still take over if you buy a lot of merch. So there was a guy like kind of off in the far corner, and he was this guy probably mid-20s, and he's on a date, and he's really focused on the date and not the show. And I can see that he's kind of trying to chatter up a little bit, but he's not loud enough that we can hear, so we don't do anything about it. We're just like, all right, they're not paying attention, fine, whatever. But the guy sitting right in front of him is a big fan, like had a Steve Hofstetter shirt and everything. And he, which by the way, I'm a little disappointed in a lot of you. And so, especially with how far your currency would go. But so, he gets, eventually, like during my set, he just goes, Steve, I'm very sorry I have to do this. And he turned, because he's British, so he had to like apologize to me before he was doing this. I know that would make him Canadian, actually. And so, so he turns to the guy and he's like, you have to shut up. You're talking through the whole damn show. I've been waiting 3 years to see him. You have to stop.
But the reason I like being a mistake, and I hope that you do too, is because we get the
sorry,
credit.
Steve. Sorry, Steve. Can you please shut the fuck up? I've waited 3 years to see this guy, and this crowd has, and all I'm hearing is you two. Please, either enjoy the show, or please go. I've waited 3 years for this guy, and I love this guy to bits, and down to bringing it, so please, enjoy the show! Woo!
That was... Wait, hold on. We got it from here. I appreciate that. Okay, wait, hold on a second. This is getting very tense right now.
And then he turns back, like everything's gonna be fine. And it was not fine, because then that other guy starts talking. I have to kind of like mediate a little bit.
Here's the thing. I can't hear you from here, but I have seen you guys chatty. So if they're freaking out, maybe you are. And if you're not, it won't be a big deal. If you're already being quiet, then it's no big deal and it'll stay the same. Okay, hold on a sec, we're not gonna escalate it. Okay, so it's just, if you were just being quiet, then you'll just stay quiet and it won't be a big deal, okay?
We're enjoying it.
Okay, I appreciate that. Okay. Thank you. Okay, guys, here, wait, this is gonna be weird, but...
And I realized, I was like, okay, the only way to do this, and I just... turn to him and his wife, and I go,
can I ask you to slide over for a sec? You guys want to come over, sit over here? Would that help a little bit?
Yeah.
All right, cool. This is a first. I did teach briefly, and I just feel like... I feel like something's going on. I don't know who's right, but I'm separating you. I appreciate it. I don't know who's right, but at the very least, this might balance out the room a little bit.
think I was talking about mistakes. Alright. So you two, I was talking to you two. For a moment when you started speaking up, I thought you were going to be like, I should have said something earlier, I am also mistaken, I feel horrible.
And so, everything was fine.
Sam, well, for two things. First of all, my apologies for interrupting Steve.
That's okay. That was, we figured it out.
Of course, the guy's been waiting 3 years has a question. He's like, fuck, I've been journaling about this one.
If you didn't have a question, I'd be a little hurt, honestly.
You should be.
Yeah, you guys are wearing my shirts.
Oh, is that you?
That's the fucking Canada shirt, and that's the one that says Steve Officer, and I see you're wearing the tour shirt. Which I very much appreciate, and yet it took like 10 minutes of the Q&A for them to be like, all right, now's the time. This is about my ex-wife now, I'm gonna fucking murder you. Okay.
That is a sandwich-based question, dude.
Sandwich-based question.
Yeah.
Okay.
In Copenhagen,
yes.
Where they have a policy about open sandwiches.
They have a policy about open sandwiches.
I wonder what your thoughts are on the sandwich.
No, all right, let's
fill me in here.
He's an American. He doesn't know where Copenhagen is. Like, he thinks it's an ice cream chain. Do you guys have that? All right, good. I was wondering if that joke was Australia only. I love this cunt so much. What was I going to say? Copenhagen. What is Copenhagen's open sandwich policy? Did you vote to remain or leave? Because, pardon? You haven't voted yet. Oh fuck, thank God they waited for you.
They gave me enough time, that's wonderful.
I just want to hear about the sandwiches, I want to experience them personally. Yeah.
So, Copenhagen, is there a rule that you can't have an open sandwich?
No, it's an open sandwich, so... Is that a sandwich or not?
So, you're saying that they're traditional sandwich. I thought you were saying there was a law on the street, like in the States, you can't have an open container. You can't have, like, an open, like, beer. And in Copenhagen, they're like, drink all you want, but these sandwiches have to stay inside.
Strong attempt at a Danish accent. Love that. Love that energy.
Came as close as possible.
Yeah.
So wait, anyone want to hear? We'll go back to this. You want to hear Dan's American accent?
Let's not do this.
Me all fucking week.
What? Do we have to do the background of the character?
Do the... No, just do the accent.
No, we're gonna do the background.
All right.
So the background, the guy's name is Dick Johnson.
Middle name Peter.
And he's always trying to learn a foreign language via a headset. That's his whole thing. So you see Dick Johnson walking around and he's like, bueno. Bueno. Bonas Diaz. Bonger. I am trilingual, Dick Johnson.
It's a pretty good accent, actually.
I caught that. Amazing.
Applause. Dick Johnson just did better with that side of the room than you did.
Cowards.
Alright, who? Sandwiches.
Do we care?
So is it a sandwich if it's not closed?
What's your thought?
No, it's sandwich ingredients.
Is this like an abortion metaphor? Like, I don't understand. It was like Seinfeld, like, is it a pizza when it goes in the oven or comes out of the oven? Like, I don't know what you're talking about. Like, are you saying, is it a bun if there's no bun on top of the other bun?
So it's two pieces.
An open sandwich is a sandwich.
It's sandwich ingredients. It's not a sandwich until you fully make a sandwich.
What? No, that's, what are you fucking crazy? Like, of course it's a sandwich. Of course, listen, you choose how you eat it.
If someone just gave you half of it without the other half, what would that be?
That'd be half a sandwich. I'd be like, where's the other half of my fucking sandwich? I want to close this thing off. Like their borders. All right. Something I know something about.
I already told them what I said in Belfast. So, who else has a question? We have time for a couple more. You guys have been awesome. Unless we
go one in the back. Wait a minute.
Yeah, when are you going to post the board?
Nicely done.
Man, fucking the crowd does callbacks. I like that. This is good.
Awesome.
See, that's about as easy as it is to start doing comedy.
That's nice. A crowd that does callbacks and heckles itself. So that's great.
Yeah, wasn't that amazing? That would never happen. Would that happen in the States? Like a crowd member just being like, sorry, Steve, excuse me, I'm so sorry. Shut the fuck up! Like, It was amazing.
No, in the States, it would just be a fight. That's all it would be. Or a woman named Karen asking to speak to the manager.
So that's Karen. Option. Excuse me, where's the other half of my sandwich? That was Karen. That was,
I distinctly ordered a sandwich, and then her date, Dick Johnson, steps in.
This isn't a sandwich, this is sandwich ingredients. I love freedom.
Who else? Did anyone else have a question? What do you got there?
Have you been to Greg's yesterday?
Have I been to Greg's yet?
Oh, I tried! I tried to take you to Edinburgh!
So, he tried to take me to Edinburgh, but I had heard of Greg's. And Greg's in the States, there's a coffee chain named Greg's with just two G's. I mean, total. Greg's has two G's at the end. Yours has three G's. Which is funny to do to people, but one of my favorite things to do is to tell someone that the word gullible is spelled with three L's. I'm like, don't know it's not. Like, yes, it is. It's not Marat.
The show ended, it was great, and then.
It was like an hour. There was like an hour between that and the end of the show. And then, like, he goes off to sell merch. I don't know if you know, but Steve has merch. Can we mention that more?
Yeah.
He goes up to do that, and I'm just like on stage, kind of like just like looking around, seeing if anyone thinks my tracksuit's cool. And then you just kind of see this commotion, and the guy sitting on the corner is like, come up in front of the guy. And like, there's like a 30 year age gap, 25
year
age
gap. Yeah, the guy who asked him to be quiet was probably in his 50s. And this guy, so we all of a sudden, we hear glasses break and tables start moving out of the way. This guy is charging for him and takes a swing.
Yeah.
Fucking hits the guy.
Yeah, he like half caught him and he was just like, don't ever fucking say that shit about me, bro. Don't ever say that. Like,
which, by the way, great way to impress your date. If you're ever looking to impress your date, act like a child. They're really into that.
Yeah, beat up someone who's your dad's age in front of her.
Yeah.
I mean, like, I am the alpha male, right? Like, that's the way to do it.
Be like, I always wanted to do this to my dad, but he left when I was young and I couldn't. Like that kind
of. What I'm saying is, I'm ready to be a father.
Anyway.
For some reason, I'm involved. Like, I don't know if you can tell. I'm not ready to settle any disputes. Like, that's not my energy. But I'm there, gonna be like, hey, like, I'll get off him. And this other guy looks like a werewolf. The guy looks like a werewolf.
To the fans' credit, 8 different people descended on this guy. It was cool. My camera was still rolling. I got to watch the whole thing later. So, 8 different people, and you might as well, depending on if it's needed in court. But 8 different people, 8 different people descend on this guy and like just peel him off. He tries to take a swing at another one and misses.
And then there's this guy at the front, he like kind of like a werewolf, but like an old werewolf. You know, like it already been a werewolf, and now he was just trying to drive a bus for a living. You know?
He's tired of being a werewolf. He's like, I've seen too much.
I've seen too many moons. Just chilling out. Anyway. Puts him in a fucking headlock, takes him down like MMA shit. And I'm like, this is wild. Like, I don't think werewolves can do anything when the moon is on out, you know? And then like he kind of gets him in a headlock, pushes him out the door. And my favorite bit of the whole thing was like it was from Leicester. I don't know anything about Leicester in England, but this was the comment at the end. He's like, mate, you know, pretty good night, but when that fight happened, fucking great night. But he came to the show the next night. The guy who got punched, not the guy who punched the guy. It's like, I fucking want round two. He came to the show the next night. It was very happy.
Yeah, came down to London, sweet guy.
Yeah, but he asked me to punch him, and I was like, oh man, I'm professional.
Yeah.
And I gave him a quick little karate chop.
Yeah, and the couple, they got married. That's the epilogue.
Yeah, Steve was the celebrant.
Yeah.
And after the ceremony, he sold merch. You know he's got merch?
That is literally how I broke the tension in the room, though, actually. When, this is 100% true, everybody's kind of like, after it gets peeled, like he gets peeled off and the guy leaves and everybody's just kind of standing like, what the fuck just happened? I just said, so does anyone want books or albums or anything? It got a laugh and then it went back to normal, so.
That's a bit of a
Sorry, that was definitely the highlight of the tour, I think. Yeah, I love that I had to, for a second, I was like, was that the, oh yeah, the horrible fight that we had.
And then I told a friend of mine from back in the States, I told her the whole story, and she was like, oh my God, did the cops come? And I was like, the cops weren't called. She's like, why not? I was like, because it's England.
Thanks for subscribing to me on YouTube and liking my page on Facebook. If you haven't yet, go do that. Also, check out the Patreon. There's all kinds of new rewards. Not only do you get to watch videos before everybody else, but I'm also posting entire shows there. Some of them from years ago. There's also fun t-shirts and lots of other stuff. Do you want to find out when I'm performing near you? If you have an American cell phone, text the word Steve to 484848. If you're in Canada, text Steve to 393939. And if you live somewhere else, let me know what a good local texting service is. Do you want to find out where else I'm performing? Go to my website, stevehofstetter.com. I'll be hitting almost 200 cities this year. If your city isn't listed yet, stay tuned. And meanwhile, bug your local venues to have me in. That stuff helps. Thanks for watching.